Hi everybody. I know it's been a long time, forgive me, I've been busy for the past 6 months, but anyway, let's get started. First of all, let me apologize for the audio. I forgot to bring my camera, so I'm recording this entirety on the Hero 7 Black. First and foremost, let's get the price out of the way. This camera, brand new, Leica Q Silver, I got it for 13,766 ringgit. Okay, so far I've covered a graduation, I've taken random shots all around, daytime, nighttime. I've done a little bit of random portraiture with this 28mm lens. And I've also taken it on a trip to Kathmandu. I went up to Chandragiri Hills, basically a cable car ride. Up and down, took some shots with it, and I gotta say I was blown away. Now this camera was my first ever Leica. I never owned a Leica, and once I got it, well, I understood what Leica stood for. Basically, when you get this camera, you're buying it for the lens. Trust me, that's about the best thing about this camera. The build quality is fantastic. Well, I've got nothing to complain about that. You've got the aluminium top and bottom, and you even have the leatherette in front. The lens is built solid. Everything on this is solid. There is no real complaints about the build quality of this camera. The buttons on these cameras are pretty well laid out. It's very simple. Got the it's either you're on off, or you have the single or continuous mode. You got the record, video record button right beside it. The shutter dial is right up here where you can just flip it around from automatic to any of the time value that you require. The aperture is pretty much simple. Removing this lens cap, yeah, it's metal anyway. Removing this lens cap gives you access to your aperture ring up here, so you can just de-click it from auto, and then you can click it to whatever range you want. The focus is as simple as pressing onto this tab and get it out of autofocus, and you can focus smoothly. Basically, you have no sounds, it's silent. You also have a macro mode on here, so you can just twist the inner ring that will give you the macro capabilities. Now, it's not really a macro function, it's just that if I'm not mistaken, I will post the figures up if I get it wrong. If I'm not mistaken, it focuses from 7 to 30 and 30 to infinity. Shutter sound is fantastic. Let me give you a demonstration, I hope you can hear it. It's so you get it locked on, and this is the shutter sound. A small little click. Beautiful. This camera is basically quite easy to control. You don't really need to fiddle around with the menu. You can obviously customize your own menu. The buttons on the back is just pretty much straightforward. You've got a function button here which you can assign for any shortcut, and you have another shortcut button up here. You've got a touchpad, and you've got touch to focus. This touchscreen on the back is only limited to certain menu items and certain settings. You can customize your menu. At the first click of the menu button, you get into your customized menu. You can't really scroll with this, but there are certain parts of the menu you can touch. Once you set up your camera, it's quite easy to use. You don't really have to fiddle around. If you need it to go into shutter priority, as I told you, you just twist this dial, aperture priority, twist this dial, and if you need manual focus, press the tab, focus in. And for manual focusing, when you start to go manual, you've got a 3x optical zoom, or you can go into 6x and you can get your critical focus just right. The EVF is fantastic. It's a 3.2 megapixel EVF, if I'm not mistaken. It's super clear. It's almost indistinguishable from an optical viewfinder with the added benefit of an electronic viewfinder. The images out of there is crisp and clear, the details is magnificent. You can get your critical focus accurately through the EVF. Okay, let me touch on the image quality. I would say this camera does not really have digital sharpness as more to detail. This lens, this 28mm lens, even at f1.7, is sharp from corner to corner. You can digitally crop in the 35 and 50mm, it basically crops in on the sensor to give you that field of view. But the downside of it is the resolution drops from 24 megapixel to 15 to 8 megapixel respectively. Dynamic range is 13 stops. Here's an example of the photo that I've taken. I exposed it for the outside, and when I took it back into Lightroom Mobile, I was able to get all this detail back. in clear clarity. Yes, there's noise, but the noise and the grain is kind of beautiful. This photo here, the panorama which I took from this camera straight, this is only a 5 megabyte image actually. But if you were to zoom in and if you were to look at all the details, they are pinpoint accurate details. The color's accurate, it does not shift, there's little to no chromatic aberration. And if you can see with this low light photo, details on the face is clear, the fire, everything, basically every photo that comes out of this, if you were to nail the exposure and nail the settings right on the camera, comes out near perfection. Now I'm just going to shut up and have a look at some of these photos for yourself. Okay, now let's talk about the downside of this camera. There's not much actually. You need to take your time with this. This camera is a bit deliberate in its operation. Face detection is there, but it's not really 100% accurate. Keep a rate of about 80% maybe, 70%. Sometimes you got a face there and the camera just does not focus on it very well. It does not have eye detection. When you are shooting still objects or inanimate objects, it's pretty much simple. When you set up the scene yourself, you can just punch into manual focus, get the critical focus and snap. But when you're on a more live event, on a party, well, you gotta keep checking your camera. You gotta make sure the shots are in focus, because I've taken a lot of photos during events and it missed. Trust me, it missed. Wi-Fi is slow. Transferring photos out of this camera to your smartphone is gonna be slow. Whether it be the JPEGs or the RAW files, it's gonna take your time. You gotta be very patient with this camera. During the graduation and also for another event, I had it on medium continuous, and I have a pretty fast card in here. When I shot a sequence of photos and I treated this like my Sony, where I didn't give it time to write to the card and I continued shooting, the buffer filled up to a point where the camera hung. So you couldn't even switch it off. You couldn't do anything, you couldn't fiddle with any of the menu items, and you couldn't shoot more. The camera was just stuck. Up to the point where I got to remove the battery and put back the battery, and I was afraid I lost my files and corrupted the card and so forth, but it did not. Lucky it did not. It still had all the files in there, and it happened to me twice. So this is not a fast camera, this is more of a street camera. A lot of reviews out there talk about the battery life being quite poor. I would say on a normal day without video, you should be able to get about 300 shots or less maybe. But when I took it up to the hill station, with the temperatures being around 9 to 10 degrees Celsius, I got about 230 shots. It's not too bad. The major downside about that is once the battery depletes, there's just no way to charge it. You got to buy a spare battery for the Leica Q if you decide to buy this new or second hand. The batteries can only be charged through the battery charger. You cannot charge this camera using a power bank, which is a real bummer. I mean, even in 2015, I guess the technology was there, but Leica just chose not to do that. You have a flap that opens up to a micro HDMI and the micro USB type connection, both of which, you don't get to charge your camera up through that way. So it's better if you could get a spare battery for this. A Panasonic battery would do as well. The accessories are expensive for this camera. It's just darn expensive. A half leather case is about 800 ringgit. A strap will cost run you about 400 ringgit. A normal thumb grip, a well-built thumb grip, but it's still plastic, that's about 600 bucks. Yeah, I know you're gonna say that, wow, you can afford a $13,000 camera, but you can't afford the accessories for it. When I spent 13,000 on this, I got what I paid for, I guess. The image quality is fine, it's fantastic. But $800 for a leather case? I gotta really think hard about it. The main complaint I had about this camera was the EVF. For some reason, especially indoors, the EVF has a blue tint compared to the back LCD and the actual scene in itself. I wasn't too happy with it. I noticed this straight out of the box when I unboxed it day one. I did use the camera for the graduation and then I sent it in to Leica to get it repaired. They brought it all the way to Singapore. They got it repaired after about a month. I got the camera back and I still feel that the EVF has a blue tint compared to the scene and the back's LCD. Now, it's not really a big deal, but if you were to nail your white balance and color, it's going to be a bit of a challenge indoors. I mean, it's bluish. It's got that slight blue tint. I'm not too sure whether that's how Leica has designed the camera or there's something wrong with it. For you Leica owners out there, if you're actually watching, could you just please let me know in the comments below if this is normal? I'm not really sure because it's my first Leica. Overall, I would like to say I really love this camera. I just gotta be honest with you. I mean, this is a beautiful camera in whichever way you look at it. Gives you great image, bang on dynamic range, color science is fantastic. It's easy to use and pretty much compact. Just sling it around your neck and carry it all day and you don't feel it. It's so well built and primarily, I mean, come on, it's the red dot. If you were to ask me if this is worth it, a Leica, not a Panasonic Leica, I would say yes. Just go for it, provided you have a spare camera with you which could do other purposes other than street photography. Anyhow, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like me to do any comparison of this camera with any other cameras, primarily my Sony 6300 with the Zeiss lens. If you would like to see those raw files or such, I'll try and get a video done on that. The Remax headphone, the one that I'll link it up here or here somewhere, you can have a look at the video. It's still up for giveaway. I just got 111 subscribers. Well, it's such a small number, but it's still something. So just to commemorate that achievement, I'll be giving away that headphone. And the giveaway is just limited to Malaysians. It's a budget headphone. The postage is going to cost more than the headphone if I were to ship it overseas. If you like it, let me know in the comments either here or on that headphone video itself and I'll just give it away to one of you guys. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you again very soon. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.